The 70s were a time of flamboyance, the big hair, the loose yet tight clothing, and the eccentric disco music created an ambience of extravagant weirdness, if you will. Yet smack dab in the middle of this cultural commotion was something much more wild, even for these extravagant times. These rather strange cases of a homicide came from New Yorker Dave Berkowitz, otherwise known as the Son of Sam. A widely known fact about Berkowitz is that he attributed his motives for the murder of 6 people, most of which were young girls, to his neighbor's dog Harvey. Berkowitz boldly made the claim that the dog would constantly talk to him, as the animal was possessed by an ancient spirit that thrived on young blood. The dog would tell him to go out and get him this blood the demon desperately needed. Also, widely known about Berkowitz is that he was schizophrenic. One of the most well-known psychotic disorders plaguing us as of now, schizophrenia is a disease that affects a person's ability to think, feel, and behave clearly. It is characterized by abnormal social behavior and failure to understand what is real, cue the hallucinations. 1.1% of the worldwide population is affected by the disorder, with over 200,000 cases only in the US per year. This is perhaps one of the most puzzling psychiatric disorders, as there is no clear cause to it, no way of fully getting rid of it, and all we have are near patterns that give us a rough glimpse into the bigger picture of this enigmatic disease. So, here's what we know. In terms of what causes schizophrenia, the researchers believe that the illness is triggered generally by uncontrollable risk factors, such as environmental and genetic elements. Like many a mental illness, this one can be passed down in the bloodline. Before we move on, keep in mind that most of these causes aren't set in stone. A lot of them are patterns noticed that patients share and, again, not the exact reason why the disease develops. Anyway, biologically, the patterns of the disorder seem to be abnormalities in brain chemistry and structure. Lack of brain chemicals, dopamine, glutamate, and serotonin have been demonstrated to be the culprits of setting off the disease. The previously named chemicals are responsible for sending messages through nerve cells across the brain. Any imbalance in any of these chemicals can cause a person to have unusual reactions to stimuli, which explains why people who suffer from schizophrenia usually have sensibility for specific types of stimuli, like bright lights and loud noises. Anyway, also biologically speaking, some research points to malformations in the brain's pathways while in the womb can lead to development of schizophrenia later in life. On the other hand, many patterns of schizophrenics point to environmental factors being a primary cause. Things like childhood trauma or social isolation present in situations like migration, bullying, and racism can trigger the disease. Along with these causes, abusive use of alcohol and drugs is persistent among schizophrenics, with most of them using them before they develop the disease, and even more after the disease has settled in, using the substance as a way to cope with the reality of their situation. It is also worth noting that there have several studies that have proved that a vast amount of schizophrenics were the sons or daughters of mothers who were ill of the flu when they were pregnant. Chances are, when you think of schizophrenia, the first thing that comes to mind are its powerful sensory hallucinations. Many of the ones suffering from the disease know that what they're seeing isn't real, but the hallucinations blur the line between fantasy and reality to the point of them not really knowing if to trust the fact that what they're seeing isn't there at all. Once the full-fledged symptoms kick in, they're divided into two types, positive and negative. When we talk about positive and negative symptoms, what we mean as in they add something to the person, or they take something away from them. In the positive spectrum, there are the distinctive intense hallucinations, in which the patients heavily blur the line between reality and the product of the mind. Delusions accompany the symptom, with delusions basically being a person believing there's something or someone they're clearly not. So if Bob believes that he's as famous as Hugh Jackman, as important as Bill Gates, or even Jesus H. Christ himself, when he is actually as insignificant as me, he is extremely delusional. Bob also might live in a constant state of paranoia, as his delusions make him believe that he's being watched or tracked. The other positive symptom is schizophrenic disorganized thoughts and speech. As they might jump from various topics rather abruptly, they are redundant in what they speak and usually make up words on the spot. Finally, there is schizophrenic disorganized behavior characterized by sudden outbursts, questionable hygiene choices, and their constant movements driven by anxiety and agitation. As for negative symptoms, schizophrenia usually takes away a person's drive or empathy. Also taken away is their willingness to be social, as many patients are socially withdrawn and are also known to be emotionally flat. Moving on, schizophrenia is one of those diseases where there is no cure available and can only be treated through specific medication like the one listed here and therapy. As hard as it is to deal with though, there is no reason to believe that schizophrenia patients can't lead normal lives. While many of these people have been the subject of social ostracism for their unusual behavior, you have to understand that not only are there schizophrenics that are fully accepted into society, but that these people are also very much misunderstood and can provide good to our culture. And while yes, there is the occasional Lee Berkowitz, there is also the occasional John Nash. John Nash was a brilliant mathematician, crippled by paranoid schizophrenia. As a professor at Princeton, he was constantly seen walking around and talking to himself in the third person, as Johann von Nassau. He wrote nonsensical letters to his colleagues and made nonsensical phone calls too. Despite this, John was fundamental to the understanding of the game theory, differential geometry, and the study of partial differential equation. All of these theories are put into practice every day in economics and are vastly important in complex decision making. People who are crippled by disorder as inconsistent as this one are forced to live lives that can be confusing, unnerving even. Fighting a disease is like fighting a small-scale war, you against the enemy that has to be vanquished. And even when the enemy comes back, you fight until it's gone. With schizophrenia, however, victims are put in a never-ending war, which they can either gain or lose control of. A war against themselves. And like with any war, like with any other disease, as hard as it is to confront, life still goes on. Must have skipped the shit.